Here we are in a quinoa field. It's a vikinga. It's on an island in the, between Fyn and Jylland in Denmark. This is the third time that the farmers they have quinoa, and the field looks very nice. But I will ask the farmer herself, who is Tine. Tine together with her husband, who is behind the camera here, Peter. And Tine, what is your impression of the quinoa this year, and what is your expectations of quinoa for the future and for the market?
I like to say that I'm very positive about quinoa, because the third time it has been a little more, what do you call it, some more wheat in it. So we have a little less expectation for this harvest this year. But I would like to say that we have those very large stems with a lot of quinoa, and that's in the what do you call it, when you have so much wheat in the field, we mostly don't have so much expectation for a good harvest. But I'm confident that it will do all right anyway.
I will say that even if you have quite a lot of wheats in the bottom here, and also some larger wheats, I think the main problem will be the harvest will be a little bit wetter than else. But the plants are so strong and look so nice that I'm sure that you will have a reasonably good yield. Mm-hmm. So what are your plans for the market? Do we have a market already, or?
I think we have a wonderful product, but we have to impress the producers of food to distribute the quinoa, yeah. Because it's quite difficult in the moment to have them convinced to have exactly this product, but. I'm quite confident of the future. I think we can manage to convince them that it's a very good product without any large amount of saponin. So
I think we will have to work on that together, and mm-hmm. I'm sure also that we will have a market for this during the next half year. So I wish you the best, and thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Quinoa produced on an island like Bågø could be a strong brand.